Good morning, my dear students. In the last two modules, we had introduced you to vectors. We have identified that there are certain physical quantities which have got both magnitude and direction. Without mentioning the direction, the physical quantity cannot be completely defined, and therefore they are given in a special category called vectors. And therefore, when they have to be dealt with, when you have to work with those physical quantities analytically or conceptually also, you require to have the mathematics of clubbing the magnitudes with the direction as well. So, vector needs a separate algebra, separate analysis. We call it as vector analysis or vector algebra, where the principles of working with vector in the analysis is told. We had mentioned about the how a vector is to be represented, how a vector is to be added to another vector, how it can be subtracted from another vector. Those principles we have discussed in the earlier classes. Now, we are going to introduce another important aspect with reference to these vectors called unit vectors. This concept of unit vectors is very important in working with vectors analytically. It becomes simpler and easier, and also very useful in the algebraical working with the vectors. What is meant by unit vector means, the very word shows that it is a vector with the unit magnitude, with unity as magnitude. If any vector is having a magnitude as one unit, whatever may be direction it has, it is called as the unit vector in that direction. What is meant by that? Suppose you have 1 newton force. This is a force which is having 1 newton magnitude. Force is a vector quantity. Such a force may be in some direction like this. Then we say this vector is unit vector in that direction. But any vector can have any magnitude in general, different magnitudes can be there for vectors. Then what is the purpose of telling the unit vector there? Because in the representation of vectors, what we said earlier, we had given a geometrical representation. If you draw a line like this as a segment, directed line segment, we can call it as a vector like this. Then A is a vector in that direction. That is one way of representing the vector. You can write like this as, say, some O n, we call it O n a vector, or you can write like this also. If you mention like this, it means that O n is a line which represents the length proportional to the magnitude, and A is that vector, therefore, and the direction is given along the arrow mark mentioned there. In this way, if you say O n is equal to the magnitude of the vector A, we write like this, magnitude means we write mod A like that. So, this is what one representation we had given. Here, we are representing the magnitude of the vector separately. This shows, this is a representation where both magnitude and direction are together. Here, only magnitude is shown. Then what about direction? Direction cannot be shown separately, because a magnitude has a direction. A magnitude along with the direction is important always. You cannot simply say a direction. A direction is something in space like that. You can't represent it. You must say along x direction, along y direction. Some sentence must come like that. If you represent magnitude, separate the magnitude of the vector from the vector, where will go the magnitude direction now? How to separately represent it there? Therefore, this concept of unit vector has been brought. Like, for example, if you take a vector A is there, it has got a magnitude given by this. Sometimes we will show magnitude simply like this also without that. That I told in the earlier modules. So, this is the vector that is the magnitude of the vector. Then what about direction? You cannot show direction separately. So what we say is, we represent like this, A cap. Now what is A cap here? It is unit vector in the direction of A. Suppose there is a vector along some direction. This A cap represents a unit vector in that direction. That means this A cap has got a magnitude equal to 1 along the direction of A. That is what it means, along the A direction. So that is what this definition means. So what happens because of that? If you take a vector A, you can represent this vector as A with magnitude there multiplied with A cap here. Now in this representation, you are showing magnitude separately. This is magnitude. This is the direction given as unit vector. Because you cannot give direction absolutely without any magnitude, we have given magnitude 1. So when vector A cap is there with magnitude 1, you multiply that magnitude with A here, the effective thing that comes up there is magnitude of A only. So this, if you come from this understanding, this A, the magnitude of A is nothing but A into 1. What is this 1? The magnitude of that vector. And direction is shown on that now. Because we can't show direction on the number like that, a representation is given like A cap there. So therefore, A cap is the unit vector in the direction of A. How do you know this? How do you get this? Very simple. When multiplication give the representation like that, see the same equation here. You can write A cap is equal to the vector A by its magnitude. That is, if you divide the vector A with its magnitude, the only magnitude gets divided there and direction remains still the same. So what you get as a quotient of this division of the magnitude is 1. And therefore, this vector A cap is having a magnitude equal to 1. So like that, the unit vector is defined. Unit vector like this can be defined for any vector in any direction you take. Say another example. Suppose there is another vector called B. You can define this vector B with a magnitude and direction in the direction along that. So this is the general understanding of B. You can get B cap by the same method, vector divided by its magnitude. Sometimes you can write even like this, B by B. So like that, in any direction for any vector, you have a representation of unit vector method. This representation, this method helps very well in the understanding of the and working of the vectors there. That is why we are giving like this. Let us see where it is going to be more useful. Further ahead, we will go to that. Suppose there is a vector here along x direction. This is the origin, suppose. This is x direction, this is x axis. And there is a vector here, some OM. It is along the x direction. Say it is A. We can write this vector just now for the notation what I gave you. We can write this vector as A is equal to OM, that is the magnitude, into A cap. You can write like that. What is A cap now? It is the unit vector in the direction of OM. Because it is in the x direction, then we can represent this in the another notation, that is the notation along x axis. We can write like this also, OM into x cap. We can write now. It indicates the unit vector x cap is in the direction of x along the x axis. So giving that, it is given here like this. So x cap is a notation given for the unit vector in the x direction. That means, like what we said, we can write the vector A like this into A cap. that is one way of representing it. Here A cap can be any general direction. When you know it is clear in the x direction, you can write like this also. A into x cap or Ax into x cap, we can write like that. Where Ax becomes the magnitude of A in the x direction. This we consider that vector is in the x direction only. Similarly, suppose the vector is in the y direction. Suppose this O n is origin, suppose. You can write here itself. See. O n suppose here. This is a vector, another vector say. This is another example I give you in the same way. Let us say there is a vector in the x direction, I call it as say x bar, y direction there is y bar, say. We can call like that. So now this vector is OM, it can be written as x into x cap, where x becomes the magnitude of the x, the vector there, and y becomes the y there as the magnitude. In the same way, here you can write y into y cap. X is the magnitude of the vector in this direction. That is one vector. This is another vector, O n. It has magnitude y, and y cap represents the unit vector in the direction of O n, that is y axis. Like that, you can represent the same vectors with the notation of x cap and y cap, provided they are in the x and y direction. So you can define like that. When you say any direction in general, suppose A like this, we write A cap there. Understand that. This is one way. Now suppose any vector is there like this. Here itself, suppose there is a vector called A. This is x axis. This vector here, this is x axis, y axis. So it has the x component here, so the angle suppose is theta. So this vector will have two components, we have told about resolution of vectors earlier. You can write this as A cos theta, that is in this direction, A sin theta in this direction. Suppose. Then if you take the sum of these two components, then you will get the vector A. That means A has two components, one is x component and that is y component. This x component is A cos theta, put an x cap there indicating the direction in which it is. Y component is A sin theta, put y cap there indicating the direction there. By triangular you can try that and see, this is A cos this, A sin theta, this is A sin theta, we have told resolution like that. So that gives you the resultant as A according to triangular. So you will find the vector A can be represented now as this. You can write vector A is equal to A cos theta into x cap plus A sin theta into y cap. That is how you can represent. What is the magnitude of A now? See from this notation. A is here. That is this length. This length is A magnitude. That length is equal to, if you take right angle triangle here, you will see that it is this component square plus that component square under root. That means this is A cos theta square plus A sin theta square. You open this one, you will know the bracket here. It is A square, common both. This is cos square theta plus sin square theta, and this is nothing but A. You know cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So it is also magnitude of A. Is A. So, if you represent like this, the components are represented separately. So, by the unit vector representation in x and y directions, you can represent the vector in terms of its components in an equation like this. This helps in the working very easily. It is very easy to work with these things. Like for example, suppose there is another vector here. I will show this vector here, this is vector A, this is vector B suppose. This is vector A. You have to put the two vectors such that in the unit vector representation suppose now. Then we can write A as A cos theta into x cap plus A sin theta into y cap. Suppose we have this angle as theta, I call it as theta 1, so we call theta 1 here. This angle made by the vector B, I call it as say theta 2 from here to there. So, we can represent the vector B as B cos theta 2 into x cap plus B sin theta 2 into y cap. We have extended the same concept to these things. Now, suppose you have to add these two vectors. Your method is you have to draw the triangular from these two, draw this one, then draw the B vector here parallel to that, and then take the third side from here, that gives you A plus B. That is our principle of adding the vectors using triangle method. Instead of doing that, you can directly add components also. I have shown this method also in the earlier. So, you can also add components. Because these two are in the same direction, you can add the components directly. That means A plus B, if you want, right? You can write as A cos theta 1 and B cos theta 2 into x cap plus A sin theta 1 plus B sin theta 2 into y cap. Now, you have represented A plus B. You have made up now, this is a different vector, it is not A, it is not B. It has got x component, it has got y component. So, like that, by representing the unit vector way in the components, you can add components directly without going into the drawing the figures and all that. If you know the geometry of them, the inclinations what they make with the x axis and y axis, you can add them directly like this also. So, adding vectors becomes easier, similarly subtracting also. Even you will see in future, even multiplication becomes easier. We will go. And when you talk about multiplication, then I tell you about those things. So, before going to that, what we have to know is, what we have understood now presently, we have to first consolidate. There is what is called a unit vector, whose magnitude is 1. It can be defined in any direction. And that vector is obtained by dividing the vector by its magnitude. That is how we get it. This is one thing what we said. Second thing is, in the direction of x and y, the x component, y components, we can be there for the vector. So, we can represent a vector in terms of the components by choosing unit vectors in those two directions, x direction and y direction. They are shown like this. That is going to be very useful for working with the vectors. Now, the same thing is represented slightly for further advantage. In general, they represent like this. To have universal representation for all these things, instead of calling x cap and y cap, I, j are used. They write like this, or sometimes they write like this also, this way or that way. Both representations are there. What is meant by I? It is nothing but x cap only. We don't use generally x caps now, we use only I cap, or I, we write it. Similarly, y. Unit vector in the y direction is defined as j, noted like that, it is nothing but unit vector in that direction. So, what is I or j? Their magnitude is 1 only. Always the component in the x direction is mentioned in terms of the unit vector in that direction, which we note as I. Similarly, all components in the y direction are represented in the y component, y unit vector, and that is noted as j. So, I and j is the representation for the unit vectors now, universal representation for unit vectors along x and y directions. Suppose the vector is, has got three components along the z component also it is there, z direction also is there, three dimensional vector is there. Then we put one more called k. So, I, j, k are three unit vectors in the x direction, in the y direction here and in z direction here. This notation is used. To make this simpler in the representation, the vector is written like this. Vector A, the same vector A can be written like this as AX into I plus AY into J. AX indicates A cos theta 1, AY indicates A sin theta 1. A cos theta 1, that is what AX is. That means X component of the vector A, component of the vector in the direction of A, in the direction of, in the X direction. That is what we represent as AX here. Similarly, the component of A in the y direction is AY multiplied by the unit vector in the direction J. So, like that you can represent. Suppose there has got three vectors, three components are there, then you have to put it as AZ into K. In three dimensions only we think of that for the time being, we can say. Similarly, you can extend notations. If you want n dimensions also, you can always extend mathematically speaking. In physics, we require these three dimensions very important. This is sufficient for us in all our mechanical problems. So, this is what ultimately we wanted to tell you. That is, you can write the vector, any vector you can represent in this form. Just suppose we have only two components like what we said here. We write AX I plus AY J. Just look into here. I am writing this figure here again for your simplicity to understand, or it is here itself anyway. You observe here, this is what we said as AX, this is what we said as AY. If this is theta, this angle is theta, what is this angle? 90 minus theta. So, AY, which is A sin theta, is nothing but A cos 90 minus theta. So, if you consider this like that, 90 minus theta, you can write the same component like that also. So, in the notation here what we said, this can be like this, A cos theta I plus A cos 90 minus theta J. So, that is how you can represent this. Automatically, this becomes equal to sin theta, you know. This is cos theta, x component. A cos theta into I, A sin theta here into J. Just like what I told earlier, if you want to get the component, the magnitude of this vector A from the components, you have to square this and square that. What is this? A square cos square theta plus A square sin square theta. This is nothing but AX square in our notation now. It is nothing but AX square plus AY square under square root. That means, if you represent a vector in this way, if you want to get the magnitude of the vector, it will be given by this equation, AX square plus AY square under square root. Similarly, if a vector has got three components, say suppose there is a vector B, it has three components, suppose BX I, BY J, BZ K, suppose. Then the magnitude of B is given as square root of BX square plus BY square plus BZ square. Sum of the squares under root. That gives the magnitude there. So, like that we will be able to get the magnitude of the vector also. So, you can get the any vector represented in the unit vector notation even then you can get the magnitude of the vector separately by squaring the components and putting them under root. So, like that the magnitude comes. This is the way how you have to use the representation of unit vectors in the working with the vectors there. So, that is what we have here. Is it clear? Now, if you look at this point once again, you call this theta as alpha, this 90 minus theta as beta. Just to see here what I am writing. The vector A now is equal to AX, I just now told you there. What is AX here? A cos theta. That is what we said. Now I call theta as alpha, so you can write as A cos alpha. Similarly, AY, it is A cos 90 minus theta. That is what I called as beta. So, you can write as cos beta. So, you can see now, this is the component A cos alpha, A cos beta. So, this alpha and beta, what is the cos alpha now you can see? X component by the magnitude of the vector. Similarly, beta is Y component by the vector magnitude A. So, like this we find these things as these things, therefore, the alpha and beta, these are known as directional cosines, we call it. Directional cosines of the vector. Suppose you got a vector with three components like this. Then you have a third axis also. That angle making with z axis we call it as gamma. And we write the angle here as, in terms of cosine, direction cosine, cos gamma is equal to A z by A, z component. So, whenever you represent a vector here, you will have three components like this given. There have three unit vectors I, j, k if they have got three components. Ax is given by the directional cosine of that angle alpha, likewise beta, likewise gamma given by these equations. You can see that. So, you can remember this, and the notation of this is to be, this is the concept to be remembered. If this is there with you, it becomes easy to work with vectors now. Let us see how we do it. How the actual problems will be in while working, how it will be, we will show an example here. Suppose there is a vector given as A is equal to 3i minus 4j plus 2k, given like that suppose. It means, this you can identify with notation what we now said. A x I, A y j plus A z k. That means the vector A has got three components along x, y, z directions given by this representation. The components are given A x, A y, A z with the figure here. It means A x is equal to 3, A y is equal to minus 4 and A z is equal to 2. Now, you want to find out the magnitude of A, suppose. You want that, say. The rule is AX square, AY square, AZ square. That means, this is square root of 9 plus 16 plus 2, this is plus 4. So, this is square root of 29. That means, this vector A has a magnitude equal to 29, root 29 units. That is what it means. So, by representing the vector like this also, you have got components separately there, you have got the magnitude vector also there separately. Suppose you want to know what angle at in which direction it is working, this A is there. Just now I told you, cos alpha, this gives you the angle alpha, which is the angle made by this vector A with x axis, that is alpha. This is beta. So, this is what A x is, this is what A y is. it will tell you what angle Ax is with reference to the original vector A. So, this can be given by what I said is the component by the magnitude of the vector. Now, suppose you apply from here. The Ax value is here 3. This is square root of 29. You can work out this and then you will get the value of alpha as cos inverse 3 by 29 under root. You can calculate the value of 3 by root 29 and refer to tables there. Cos inverse will give you what the angle the alpha is. That is the angle at which it is working with respect to x axis. Similarly, you can find the cos beta. Here it means A y by A. Minus 4 by root 29. Once again, the same way, you can find this angle also, the angle made with the y axis by this formula. This way you can find it. Similarly, the angle made by the vector with the z axis also can be known. Here the component is z component and the answer is 2 by root 29. So, gamma is cos inverse 2 by root 29. So, by just representing the vector like this, by remembering the concept of the representation, we could know the magnitude of the vector, we could know the direction of the vector also by knowing three different components separately. So, all this information is just there embedded in one equation itself. That is why the unit vector representation of any vector is much more advantageous for working, is simpler and easier also for working. Understand? So, that is the advantage what we have here. I will give another example of working with these unit vectors. Suppose you have to add two vectors or subtract two vectors. Then, once again, unit vector representation becomes suppose a vector is given by A 2, 3 I minus 2 k and there is B like this. Suppose you want to find A plus B now. Instead of drawing the vectors on the geometry, going to directions and all that, you can analytically work it out here directly. This is nothing but adding these two. See, we can observe one thing also before adding here. In this, I component is there, K component is there, J component is missing. It means there is no component for the vector in the y direction. Similarly, here I component is not there. So, vector B does not have a component in the I direction. So, the resultant of these two, when you add up, you will see, you will get as components of like things to be added. I should be added. Here there is no I here. Here there is no J. There is J in the second one. And there minus 2 K plus 7 k. We can write this simply as 3 I minus 3 j plus 5 k. Now, you can see the sum of the vector A and B has a component in y, z and k direction also, because these two are different planes. This is I k plane, that means x z plane. This is y z plane. One is along the x z plane and there is the y z plane. But the resultant will be therefore maybe in a different plane altogether. In that plane, it has got all the three components here now. So, like that, you can understand this vector A. Now, once you know A plus B, you can get the magnitude of A plus B also. Just like what I said, square root of 9 plus 9 plus 25. That is the value what we have. 16 plus 25, it is root 41. 18 plus 25, 43, square root of 43. So, you can find like that A plus B. Similarly, suppose you want to find A minus B. It is nothing but A plus minus B. So, that means 3 I minus 2 k plus minus b minus 3 j, I will put like this, minus 3j plus 7k. Just for clarity, I am putting like that. It is nothing but simply 3i minus 2k. This becomes plus 3j minus 7k. This is now 3i plus 3j minus 9k. You can see that. So, a minus b means that a minus of minus plus, this becomes minus, so becomes 9. So, now you can find a minus b magnitude also, a minus b magnitude also you can find if you want. And that is square root of 9 plus 9 plus 81. No. It is 18 square root of 99. So, further whatever simplification is possible, to put the answer ultimately you can do it like that. So, whatever it is, working with unit vectors therefore becomes easier in the addition. You can see subtraction it becomes easier. You can have number of vectors like this. Even you have got number of vectors like this, a plus b plus c plus d plus and so on like that, any number, it becomes easier because you are only adding the components algebraically, just like algebraic addition, it becomes easier for you to understand that. So, that is how it is very useful, advantageous in representing vectors in the form of unit vectors notation. Get accustomed to this. In further future, whatever vectors we will be doing, most of them will be representing in this way only. So, that will help you to get to the practice of that. Attempt some of the problems given there in your module and then you will know how it is very simple as well as useful. Thank you.